Thank you very much again for this synthesis and this opening up with the trends in terms of technological approach. Thanks very much. It was very useful. Now we are staying in the same subject, really, but with a more marketing angle. You had more technological angle because Stéphane Lebas is a director of marketing at SFR. Stéphane was part of our group, that workshop we conducted last year. And he will tell us his vision of privacy, again, from more marketing angle. Stéphane.
Thank you. I just have a few slides and few real and pragmatic examples, and I just would like to emphasize on user experience and user-centric approach. So I was very happy to have speakers this morning and this afternoon talking about having more user-centric approach. And I think that definitely it's part of the issue and part of the solution. So just to start, what we can see, I just take one example because there is many on the web, of services, an application directory, app.net, which already use privacy as a competitive advantage. And there is a lot of other services using privacy as a feature. And when you look at, I just copy-paste some of the text on the website, so it's really the way it's explained and illustrated to the user. And if you look at the words that are used, they are talking about our most valuable asset is your trust. They are talking about your content. We will never sell your post, your private message, your photo. We will never sell your personal data, we promise. So if you look at the word, it's a very strong word. And so it's good news to see such services really relying on user privacy. But there is one point which I'm disturbed by, is the there is always, if you look at the text or in the blog on all the explanation behind, there is always implicit or explicit criticism to other service providers. They say many people have become so cynical about user hostile, privacy violating social services. So the question is not to complain about the competition. The question is not to present privacy as always a risk. They are not only here to protect the user. We have to think about privacy more in terms of value creation. And not only regarding the needs to protect customers. And the best way to create value is to share the value. Because as Nicolas told us before, there is a lot of value in personal data and in big data. But to start to protect the value, you need to share it. And some startups are already also starting to promote privacy plus personal data monetization. So again, it's two examples. But what is very interesting is that there is a mix of a claim of monetizing your data and using privacy tool. It's always the same way of presenting privacy. You have in the two situations a safe repository box. And the best way to share the value from their perspective is to share the money. Again, I think it's maybe not the best way to convince people to share their personal data, to just have a monetary angle. And maybe it's better to rely on other benefits for the end user, and to rely on other value proposition. And another thing which is funny for me, so they claim that you can register and put your personal data, and you will be able to manage your personal data and to get money from it. So your personal data is supposed to be safe and private, but they don't forget to put some button to publish the value of your data on the social network. Which is like a paradox. If we look to other large corporation or mass market services, we have to admit that many of them are just implementing a very basic set of privacy features and requirements. What I mean, it's basically it's always cookie management, having some opt-in, some opt-out, some privacy policy, and the question is always the same: how do I minimize the impact on the customer experience? So having very small privacy section, having some hidden place to have the opt-out capabilities. And so really the question is how to switch from switch the question and to switch from what is the impact on user experience to what is the benefits in terms of user experience. So really the large corporation need to see privacy not as only something you have to comply to, but really benefits in terms of value creation. And if you don't you don't want to go in the debate around money, maybe you have to focus on user experience. And user experience is not just only recommendation, but it's allowing the user really to understand what he's doing on internet and having a seamless navigation. Again, from a user perspective, from a user-centric perspective, there is a paradox. When you ask, every single customer is concerned about privacy. So I take online customer study from 2011, but it's always the same situation. When you ask the customer, everyone is concerned. Everyone is concerned in the room, but we are talking about privacy. But if you go in the street, it's not the first concern of people. When you look at who do you think should be responsible for managing and guarding online privacy, half of the people say, it's my job. It's my job, it's my responsibility to take care about my privacy. But as it was told this morning about the consent or do not enter or informed consent fallacy, every single user, when he uses a smartphone or a service, is validating terms and conditions on term of use with a privacy concern without reading it. There is another study that told that half of the people never read once in their life terms and conditions. Never. So if you would like to have fun, you can try to read all the terms and conditions on your iOS device. It will take you some time. Or even there is a lot of Twitter reminder in the room. Even if you look at Twitter, if you look at the what you allow Twitter to do on your Android device, it's scaring. They are allowed to have your location, GPS and network, to modify or delete content of your mass storage, to have access to network connection, full access, to modify your call log, to see your contact detail, to modify your contact detail, and so on and so on. So the truth is that today, most of the people, they just don't care. They're just validating such terms and conditions. And so our job is to be able to convince the end user and the service provider that there is value to change such situation. And at the end of the day, it's a question of user experience. When I would like to download an app, I will have a direct download. I don't want to read all the terms and conditions. Same for activating my iPhone. So at the end of the day, it's a question of user experience. And service providers, they are using user experience against privacy regulation. So now, just have a look on a real personal data exposition trial we have done in France with Alcatel-Lucent and with Orange and Bouygues. So it was just a trial. It's over right now. But it was an attempt to find a good mix between privacy and value creation. So we start with the business question. So the figures are not fully accurate, but we can say that now, for some e-commerce services, 30% of the acquisition of new customer is coming directly on mobile. So people are discovering the services on mobile. It represents 10% of revenue, but if we look at the detail, only 30% of people that download the application go until the end of the registration process, because it's very painful. You have to put your name, your address, phone name, date of birth, email address, passcode, and so on. So the business question is how to boost registration rate for e-commerce on application and smartphone, which is a very interesting question. So what we have done in France on that, what we call the Uconnect trial, it was a way to allow the application to get automatically all the personal data information to complete the registration process very quickly. So basically, you ask to register, and then you have the registration form, and you just have 3 clicks to acknowledge to use the data from your mobile operator. And basically, it's name, forename, date of birth, email, postal address, fixed number, mobile number, gender. And what happens, the telco is not sending the data to the service provider, no. It's just sending the data to the application locally. And until the customer could have modified the data or acknowledged the data, is totally in control of the data. And it just after 3 clicks of customer consent, that the data are transmitted to the service provider. So really, the user is in the middle of the relationship between the third party and the telco, and the user has full control over its privacy and even the content of the data, because he could even modify it at the end. And what was also interesting is that from a technical perspective, it was based on open API approach. So talk about before in the speaker talk about code is low. So really, it's based on having an open API and open using open authentication mechanism to do the pilot, and it was of course fully compliant with French regulation. And just to conclude, three open questions. So first of all, my opinion is we have to better leverage on user experience to educate customers on privacy on one end and the benefits of data sharing on the other end. As it was told also before, to give back control and value to the customer in order to onboard them. And as you said this morning, but that's my personal opinion, I think that maybe a tipping point will be the day where there will be a massive security or privacy breach. And maybe it's the only solution for the mass market to really take, to be aware of the concern about privacy.